another very important to young people is when you do well, and if you are with a good mentor, okay, you should do so well, then when you leave that place, the people have to remember all their life till they die. Okay, so I not that I did it with that aim. And this Ira Paston is a reasonably big guy. On numerous forum, he's taken that it was all because of Vijay Chaudhary breakthrough. So when this drug came, I think he was being interviewed. This slide is not to brag about. So one of my students brought out this. Sir, do you know that Ira Paston remembers you even after 29 years in the same way as he must have admired you? So another piece of lesson is do something which leaves an imprint on wherever you are. If you are a PhD student, your supervisor should remember all your life, all his life or her life. If you are in a job, that means your departure should make somebody sad. They will be happy for your future, but then they should remember. So I feel very proud that Ira Paston, very, very big guy, okay, remembers exactly the same way even after 29 years of my departure. So I'm not in regular touch. I probably write to him once in a year because there is no collaboration. Okay, but he remembers. And then for this work, this award came from Director's Award, which is never given to visiting associates. So they made a very special, because I had made so many contributions. Another very piece of, sometimes, you know, we run after money. You know, many people will do IIT and then they'll go for MBA and then do a job in a bank. What a future, you know. I mean, all waste of technical knowledge. But money can be earned at any time. Fortunately, our salaries are good. But if you are really innovative, you're really hardworking, and you have a right thing in hand at the right time, you can earn any amount of money. I have a capability to earn equal to my salary as a consultancy. Okay, but you have to be a little different. Okay, and then for my US work, until last year, I used to receive $600. And in many years, half yearly, I have received up to $10,000. So that means, I mean, that is how one can sustain. And I did not value for the money, but money will flow. Even from the Indian work, tens of lakhs of rupees have come as a royalty, actually. So money is, but you have to be consistent. You have to be good. So lastly, in last 5-7 years, we have developed a technology. What Greg Winter did 20 years ago, or 30 years, 25 years ago, phase display technology to discover antibodies. He did it. He made a company called Cambridge Antibody Technology, which gave the molecule Humira. Not he, that company, because those companies are small. Once they make a discovery, they are given out to a larger company and they make the molecule. Discovery, from discovery to making a usable molecule is a very, very long journey. Okay? And I have never done it, but I know contours of that journey. Okay? Therefore, for last almost 25 years, I never ventured into even thinking about any therapeutics. It's so difficult. But then, in last 5 years, we have made this library, and this library, maybe at some other time, because it is very complex, the quality of our library which we have made, it has got 10 billion types of clones. Okay? And based on the literature survey, because we have got the Indian patent granted also in 20 months' time, we compared with every virtually available library, much, much superior. Okay. So for this library, very recently, couple of months ago, again, DBT gave us this biotech award. So we have received, our lab has received biotech awards 3 times in last 20 years. Okay. This was the slide which I got it incorporated last night, but unfortunately it will not work. Based on this work, this quality of the library, there are two or three more PowerPoints. As I said, all antibody discovery started with immunization of horses, anti-rabies horse, anti-tetanus horse, even today, anti-diphtheria after 120 years, and anti-vicinic venom. Somehow, about 18 or 20 months ago, I got introduced to people working in the field of snake bite, and then I realized how big is this problem. In India, worldwide, there are about 4 million bites, and more than 100,000 people get killed, and about 400,000 people get disabled. Because after bite, you are given treatment. But treatments are so inefficient that it does cure you of the toxicity. But wherever the toxicity occurs, the bite occurs, that portion becomes, you know, you have to ampute. Or you have to treat by plastic surgery. Okay, so there are permanent disability of 400,000 people. That is the estimate by the WHO. And unfortunately, half of this, 50,000 deaths, 2 million bites, and 200,000 these numbers. I mean, all happen in India. So we are not half a world, but we harbor half of the snake bite problem. Okay, so there are groups in Tejpur, everywhere, they're working on the venom composition, and that they've added a lot of value, but nobody works on the treatment. So when we got this technology in hand, I contacted, I told DBT that this is what we should do, and they asked me to create a mission. And this mission, I think I presented in that DBT meeting, that very we have been working on this planning of the mission for last 1 year with many, many partners. And then we have divided, the venom has to be collected very, then venom has to be characterized, then antibodies has to be created, so we can take care of this. And the diagnostics have to be developed. And then when we were making presentation in May this year to the DBT secretary, she said, you've got so much of a strong technology, why would you not like to let it be used by others? So therefore, create a center which will empower, which will train, which will transfer the skill of yours to others so that they can work on other targets. Okay, so we have worked out the whole detail. This project got submitted last week. Probably in a couple of months, we'll see that it's a very large project, you know, tens of crores and multiples of partners, including the industry. So we are submitted for the first 5 years. We know what should be the next phase, and so on and so forth. Okay. I wish those movie had worked. So I'll end that antibodies are very versatile molecules. And there has been so many advancement in antibody technology that it is possible to create any antibody to any molecule, that means the specificity of any affinity. Okay. And but however, as I said, we can discover antibody in IASST or in South Campus, but beyond that, it is in the industry. So you will not believe, for the snake bite project, though the first phase has no clinical role of clinician, but I have requested the best of the clinical person in this field to be the partner, right, to guide us whether we are going into the right direction to create the molecules which will be useful for the clinic. Right from the day one, there are 2-3 industries which are into making of recombinant protein, or they are already making the horse antisera. Okay, because unless you bring those people together, they have to guide us where we are going wrong, because ultimately they will have to take lead forward. And finally, thank you. And all this work does not have, I don't do it. Actually, I do a lot of bench work, fortunately. A lot of bench work, actually, equal to a PhD student. And I'm very fast in working. So I will not say that I do not do work. But most of this work is done by students, supported by advisors, mentors, and associates, and then collaborators, and of course, the funding agency. Fortunately, all my funding has been only from DBT. And the last funding for making this library was from Nimitli. So DBT has been really, you know, the mother of everything. Thank you very much.
Antibodies are Y-shaped protein molecules made by our body that bind to disease-causing cells and help in their elimination from the body. These disease-causing cells can be bacteria, virus, parasites, or even our own cells, as in the case of cancer and autoimmune disorders. For over a century, animals have been used to make antibodies for use as therapy in humans. This includes antisera against rabies, tetanus, diphtheria, and snake bite. But these antibodies of animal origin lead to toxicity and severe side reactions in the human recipients. With technological advances in the last 2 decades, it is now possible to make completely human antibodies for therapeutic purposes. At Sidret, University of Delhi, we have created the technology to isolate completely human antibodies against any target. This recombinant human antibody technology is completely indigenous and the first and only technology of this kind in our country. It is immunization free and completely avoids the use of animals. This technology has 2 components. The first component of the technology is a phage displayed naive human antibody library. To create this, antibody genes isolated from human blood cells were cloned into a arch display system so that functional antibody fragment gets displayed on the surface of a bacteriophage. Each phage has a different antibody on its surface, and like this, we have a library of 10 billion phages, each displaying an antibody of a different specificity. The second component of the technology is a platform for isolation of antibodies from this library against any potential target. In this antibody discovery platform, the target is immobilized and acts as a bait to fish out specific antibody binders from the library through a process known as panning. Multiple rounds of panning lead to selection of high affinity, high specificity antibodies. These selected antibodies are then transferred to a mammalian expression system for production of gram quantities of full-length, completely human antibodies against the desired target. This technology is the basis for next-generation therapeutics for global health emergencies, including HIV, antimicrobial resistance, snake bite and venoming, cancer, and autoimmune disorders. This recombinant human antibody technology is currently being employed for producing next generation treatment for snake bite.
Thank you.